the Virgin Rapids. She loves the theater, but would never come here late. She never bothered with any folks she hates. That is why the lady is a tramp. Doesn't like card games with sharpies on boards. Won't go to Harlem driving Lincolns or Fords. Won't dish the dirt with the rest of the broads. That's why the lady is a tramp. She loves the free fresh wind in her hair. Life without care. She's broke, that's old. It's California, it's old and so very damn. That is why the lady, that's why the lady, that's why the lady is a tramp.
Shotgun, they say, that's why I'm such a wonderful
Sheriff's office and asked them if they would like there, I couldn't keep my eyes off of you. After we were introduced, we danced the rest of the night together.
And you left the next day. I wondered if I'd see you again.
Well, I was on my way to see the governor, but I came back, didn't I?
Oh, yes you did. Several times.
And I kept my promises to you too, didn't I?
Yes. We were married on January 6th in the year 1759, right here in New Kent County. That following spring, I left my beloved home here for your home at Mount Vernon.
We spent the next 16 years up in Mount Vernon. Life was very busy up there. We had decisions to make about whether to continue with tobacco or to go with some more profitable crops. Life was very much the same up there as it was down here at White House.
And there were parties. You know how I loved my parties. And watching our children grow.
Yes. You were the perfect wife. I remember you took care of the children and the home, and I continued to serve Virginia in the House of Burgesses.
My only sadness came when our Patsy died. She was such a feeble child, but so loving. I miss her. And then the conflict grew with King George in Parliament, and you went to Philadelphia. I wondered when I would see you again.
Well, the Congress sent me right up to Boston to take charge of the Army.
And I stayed home, as I should. I wrote you letters often.
You were the perfect Army wife, following me to winter encampments wherever you could, wherever they might be.
The worst one, Valley Forge, it was so cold there. I felt so sorry for the soldiers.
Oh, those were hard times for all of us. But the hardest times for you were yet to come, when we lost Jack at Yorktown from the camp fever.
Yes, it almost broke my heart. My last surviving child gone.
I felt so responsible. He was there with me.
There, there, George, it wasn't your fault. A great many people died of fever in those days. But let's not discuss that now. These folks aren't here to hear sad memories. There were a great many good memories, like our trips here to New Kent to check on things for our grandchildren. It did my heart good to be back home on the shores of the Pamunkey River, where I grew up and started my family.
And this is still a great place to start a family. Why, do you know that there are nearly 20,000 people living here? Can you imagine?
20,000? Are you sure of that number? It seems like a great deal to me. Do they still have the plans for growing tobacco on like my father did?
Oh, Martha, you still are living in a different century. Even up in Mount Vernon, we had switched over from tobacco to wheat and corn because it was more profitable.
I'm growing so addled. Perhaps we should say goodnight to these folks, all of them. Bless your hearts for coming this evening. We so love talking about the old days, but we are growing a bit weary. We'll take our leave of you now. Good night.
Good night.
Aren't they just the perfect couple? And they met right down the road from here. Amazing.
Yes, the perfect couple. Just like Adam and Eve. Sonny and Cher, Mark Anthony and Cleopatra, and Vint and Sammy and...
Wait. Who are Vint and Sammy?
Well, they're our only local ventriloquist and her dummy.
back to our previous conversation. I'm still amazed that we have unpaved roads here in the county. However, in regards to the roundabout situation, I've got that under total control.
Well, get ready. There'll soon be another one at the intersection of 612 and 249.
Is that what Dirty Pool Road comes in at 249?
Now you're getting it.
You're going to laugh at this. The first time I went on around the roundabout at 106, I drove around it three times and got so confused I ended up at the winery having a
must use the aged roadkill. To which you add two Hanover tomatoes. They must be Hanover tomatoes. Any other tomato would just not be the same. To that we add one onion, peeled, not sliced or diced, but whole. And then to the coup de gras, we add one quart of pomegranate.
suggested that I run for the Board of Supervisors. I know that we're one of the largest growing communities in Virginia, and I want to know what's going to happen in the next 20 years so that I can be a leader in change.
You plan to be on the board for the next 20 years?
Oh, my, yes. Once you get on the board here in New Kent, you can run until you, well, you know, until you're ready to retire. It's a lifelong commitment. So tell me, what's going to happen?
Okay. Well, first, the number of stoplights will double to 12. One will be added on the Route 106 to help with the flow of truck traffic, and another will be placed on 249 to slow down the high school students coming and going to school.
Good luck with that.
And one will be added near Antonio's, because Colonial Downs will be torn down, and a complex of 300 new town homes will be built alongside a new elementary school to accommodate the children from the town homes.
What is that going to do to our way of life here?
Just be patient. I'm still speaking of stoplights.
I'm listening.
Well, traffic will increase so much in Bottoms Bridge because of the addition of a Dunkin' Donuts, a Pancake House, Antonio's West, Arby's, Popeye's, a CarMax, a laundromat, and Walmart. Alongside the new emergency care facility. So we'll need to help with the traffic just down the road from the existing light that's already there.
Wow, that really is progress.
Well, some might say that.
Amazing. What else?
Well, you know where Thunderman Farms is, right?
Right past the post office, you turn left. There used to be a town back there in colonial days, but there's nothing there now. Why would we need a light there?
Well, the man who owns Cumberland Farms decided to take a page out of J.D. Rockefeller's notebook and recreate the colonial village. All he had were some old maps, but that was enough. Once that happens, people will flock to Cumberland Farms. They'll bypass Williamsburg because Cumberland Farms is cheaper and cleaner than Williamsburg. So we'll need a stoplight at Cumberland Road and 249.
Wow, that's amazing. What about the last one?
Oh, that one will be in the next.